Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part four of sets, and we're going to do problems involving more than one steps. On this video, we're going to use this for the universal set, the numbers from 1 to 9. And we've got three subsets, A, B, and C defined as following, and then we're going to do the following four problems. Here's the first problem. Find B complement minus A union C. Now remember, this is not regular subtraction, this is the difference operation, right? It's the difference of two sets, a little bit different. So B complement, what does that mean? That means everything in the universal set except B, the elements in B. So everything except 4, 5, and 7 will be 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, and 9 minus, okay, why don't you figure this part out? What's A union C? Write that down. That means we're joining together all the elements in A or C. So if it's at least in one of them, it gets in the union. So I have all the elements of A, 1, 4, 7, and 8, and also anything in C gets put in, so I have a 2. I already have a 7 in here, so I don't write that down again, and a 9. And now, what do I do? Do you remember? You want anything left in this first set, right, which is B complement, that's not over here on the right. So let's see. Do I get to keep the 1? No, because there's a 1 over there. I get to keep the 2? Nope, because there's a 2 over there. Do I get to keep the 3? Yes. Do I get to keep the 6? Yes. Do I get to keep the 8? No, because there's an 8 over there, and I don't get to keep the 9. So final answer here is what's left is only 3 and 6. Right, here's the second problem. Why don't you go ahead and put the video on pause and try this on your own first? All right, so we have to do A intersect B to begin with. All right, so we look at sets A and B, and their intersection is whatever elements they have in common. And they have a 4 and a 7 in common, so that's 4 and 7. We're going to union that with A take away C. All right, so that's a little complicated to do in your head, but maybe you could do it. If you look over here at A, we've got 1, 4, 7, and 8. Are any of those over in C? I've got 2, 7, and 9. Well, there's a 7, so I can't keep the 7 in A. So what's left will be the 1, 4, and 8. If you want, you could write down what A is, right? And say, I got to take the 7 out, right? That's just sort of like scratch work over here. And now I want to take the union of these two sets. So what numbers are left? Well, they have a 4 in common, but all the rest of them are unique numbers. So I have the 1, the 4, the 7, and the 8. Doesn't matter the order you put the numbers, right? I could put 4, 7, 1, 8. Doesn't matter as long as I use my braces and my commas to separate the numbers. All right, here's the next one. Same universal set, same three subsets. C. Well, that's easy to do, isn't it? But I'm going to have to do a couple of things over here. I have to do the A union B and take the complement first. So for now, I'm not going to write out this just to make it a little bit easier. And let's write out what A union B is to begin with. Okay? So A union B, if you look between these two sets, if it's in A or B, it gets in the union. So I get all of A, 1, 4, 7, and 8, and all of B, which is 4, 5, and 7. Well, I've got a 4 already, 5 I don't have yet, and I have a 7 already. Right, so they're in this set, those five elements are A union B. And now I have to take the complement of that. Okay? Now I'm going to go ahead and write down what's in C right now. That's 2, 7, and 9. And what's the complement of this set? 1, 4, 7, 8, and 5. Everything in the universal set except those five numbers. So what's left? 2, 3, there's a 5, how about a 6 and a 9? Right? Those are all the numbers in the universal set that are not 1, 4, 7, 8, or 5. Last step. So now we have to do the set difference. So we have to see what do we get to keep from this first set. All right, can I keep the 2? No, because there's a 2 over here. So we have to take that out. The 7, there's no 7 over there, so I can keep the 7. 9, have to take that out because of that 9. So our final answer will only have a 7 inside the set. So there's the answer. Last one. Again, try this one on your own. Make sure you do what's in parentheses first, then take the complement, and then subtract a. So put the video on pause to give yourself time to do this. All right, so let's see. We're going to do B intersect C. So I'm going to write what B intersect C is. I'm going to look at these two sets, B and C, and do they have any elements in common? Only a 7. So that's only 7. And I could write out all of A, but I know I'm going to do one more step, so I'm going to save myself some extra writing and do that the following step. Now I've got to take the complement of this set that only contains 7. Well, that's every number from 1 to 9 except 7. Right? That's the complement of this set that contains 7. And subtract anything out that's in A. And A is 1, 4, 7, and 8. So what do I have to take out of here? Does the 1 get to stay in? No, because there's a 1 over here. Does the 2 get to stay in? Yes. Does the 3 get to stay in? Yes. How about the 4? Nope, because there's a 4 over there. 5 gets to stay in. 6 gets to stay in. 8? Nope, because there's an 8 over there, so that gets taken out. 9 gets to stay in. So what's left here is 2, 3, 5, 6, and 9. And there we've got it. Right, so I've done 5 videos on sets using the set notation, and we've only been doing sets where we can actually write the universal set. So in other words, it's a finite number of elements in each set. And I'm going to do a video on Venn diagrams, so if you want to know a little bit more about sets, then you want to go on to the next video on Venn diagrams. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.